Thank you very much, Miraya FM, and thank you very much, Bakita Radio, for this brief interview. Africa OK Foundation is a national NGO registered in South Sudan. We had an opportunity to attend an orientation meeting organized by JMEC, and in that workshop, the chairman of the National Constitution Amendment Committee, in his presentation, told us that they are already receiving submission to the Political Parties Act and the National Election Act. To that effect, we took it upon ourselves that the voice of the youth must be heard in these two political processes that must involve the participation of youth. So we took it upon ourselves to start reviewing the law and to start looking at other relevant political parties and National Election Act laws of countries in Africa that are very democratic and that have been practicing the democratic principles, and how the youth have been included into the political parties and any political process. So I am very happy that today we are having a two-day youth consultative workshop on the Political Parties Act and the National Election Act. On the first day, we are looking at our recommendations to the proposed amendment to the Political Party Act, which is in conformity with the agreement on the resolution of conflict in South Sudan that mandated the National Constitution Amendment Committee to review these two legislation. So we will be presenting our position as the youth of South Sudan, because these are very important events or processes that are happening in this country that we, our voice must be heard. So we are happy to have even members of parliament from the Transitional National Legislative Assembly. We are happy to have members from the political parties. We are happy to have members from other youth groups, including the National Youth Union and other university students, because we believe that we must have an inclusive process that includes the civil society organization, the political parties, youth, and another group of youth, including even the members of parliament, so that this will become an advocacy tool for the youth to use in advancing their role and their obligation in the political life and even in the national election process. Because election is not an event, election is a process. So the process begins from formulating and legislating a very important and very fundamental law that must guarantee the participation of everybody. So what we are doing for the 2 days is that looking at the law itself and looking at the lacunas that are in the law, and looking at how do we litigate those lacunas and how do we ensure that the next coming law has the views of the youth of this country. Although we lack of resources, we could not be able to move around the country, but we believe that these people who are representing the youth are also from the association and will be open to receive views from other youth groups, because this is a very important opportunity for us. So what we'll be doing is that on Wednesday, we are going to make submission to GMEC, to the National Constitutional Amendment Committee. We already notified them. We already got acceptance notification from the chairman of the National Constitutional Amendment Committee, giving us the audience on Wednesday from 10 a.m. And then from then, I will be able to do our advocacy and civic education, our position paper as a youth on these two important legislation. Because whether it's next year, whether when, we must have elections in the future. And these elections must be conducted using these two laws, the Political Party Act and the National Election Act. So we have a real fundamental recommendation that it is our hope and prayer that the committee and even beyond the committee, they will be able to look at this. So we are not even at the committee level of the National Constitutional Amendment Committee. We are even going as far as to Parliament. That's why we have invited members of Parliament who are young people, so that they are able to use this as an advocacy tool in Parliament. We will even be meeting other government officials, so that these ideas of ours does not end in the committee level. We ensure that at least, if not all, most of the ideas are incorporated, including the political participation of the youth. We must have a say in the political parties. We must have a say in election process that are happening in this country. So these are processes that ensure that the country is democratic. So we're looking forward for that fruitful discussion, and we want to thank, very important, categorically, we want to thank Norwegian People's Aid, NPA, for supporting this process, because they facilitated this process to ensure that all the logistics are put in place. So we really thank them so much, and we believe that this is not going to be the end of the support they will be giving to the young people. So we will not be ending here. You, the people, the young people out there, you should expect us to be speaking to them on our position paper, that we will consolidate all our position papers. So we have one position paper as the youth of South Sudan on these two important legislation.
Okay, what do you expect out of this consultation paper?
We expect to have one unified position paper as the youth of South Sudan on the two important legislation. We'll be finishing today, which is the 27th of November, we'll be finishing with the Political Parties Act, our recommendation, and we'll consolidate all the position paper from other groups today. Tomorrow we'll be looking, which is 28th of November, we'll be looking at the National Election Act. We'll also consolidate all the views and all the ideas, so we'll be coming with two position paper, one on the Political Party Act, which is our recommendation to the committee, and beyond the committee, I told you beyond committee, which means the Ministry of Justice, the Parliament, the Speaker, is going to be beyond the committee. Because when the committee have drafted their proposal, we will also look into those proposals and see and advocate that at least before even the President could sign the amendment of the Political Party Act bill or the amendment of the National Election Act bill, we'll have to ensure that at least most of our ideas as the young people are incorporated into this, because we are the future of this country, of not tomorrow, but of now. That means we really have to participate in the governance and the political processes of this country. So this is very important. So we expect the end of this workshop, we expect to come up with a unified position that we will present to the committee on Wednesday from 10 a.m. Then thereafter, we'll now continue with our advocacy.
Okay, just to be brief, it looks like the proposals you are presenting and then the members you got at consulting or they're discussing about, it looks like an idea or something that has come from an organization. What prompted this?
Yes, what prompted this, I said earlier on that Africa OK Foundation got an opportunity to be invited by JMEC for a youth workshop, orientation workshop on the implementation of the peace agreement. So in the presentation, we had a privilege as the youth of South Sudan to hear from the National Constitution Amendment Committee chairperson. So when the National Constitution Amendment Committee chairperson briefed us and told us that they have already done with the incorporation of the agreement into the transitional constitution, which is within the provision of the agreement, they also reviewed the SPLA Act of 2009, which is already with the, I think, Council of Ministers, is going to Parliament. And right now, they're reviewing the Political Parties Act and the National Election Act, which is in conformity of the provision of the agreement. So what prompted us is that we say these are very important legislation. And to be honest, there are serious lacunas in both two laws. So as young people, we took it upon ourselves that we reviewed, we look at the legal implication of this law and where does it fit.
First, wait, you said lacuna. Somebody else, ordinary person outside there.
Lacuna means gaps, the gaps within the law. So there are gaps within the law. So we feel those gaps need to be filled up. And those gaps that does not favor the youth is what we're looking at. So Africa OK Foundation took the lead, because that process, you must have somebody who take the lead. So Africa OK Foundation took the lead, but we consulted, we shared the document with most of the youth group. We shared with them through emails or through other form of information. We shared the document with them. And some of the ideas, we got feedback from them, which we incorporated into a document. Right now, in fact, we are even reviewing. We have given them the document, the draft document, for them to review to see what need to be omitted, what need to be added. So this is not going to be something that is Africa OK Foundation position. It's going to be a position of all the youth leaders who have gathered here today and who have congregated to look into this document. So we have already given the document. They're already reviewing it. So we are also going to hear the recommendation, which we will incorporate and come with a final document. So that's what prompted us. We want to participate in every political process. And lastly is that the chairman said the last day of submission is on the 30th of November 2017, which is in fact on Thursday. So we had to beat the deadline before the end of submission, because We wanted this process to begin from the committee level before it goes to the parliament. So that if the committee does not give us the opportunity, we still have other opportunities that we can venture in. Because from the committee level, you have to go to the Minister of Justice. So we still have other processes. So that's why we're saying, let's start from the committee level. If they don't buy in our ideas, some of our ideas that we have put here, which is very fundamental, by the way. For example, let me just mention an example. For example, we are talking of issues of internal democracy. And this is something which has been lacking in the previous law. The issue, because internal democracy and institutionalization of political parties. We have been seeing past of the years, political parties are formed based on individuals. But we are saying, look, the law must address issues of political parties based on the principles of institutions. So, and those principles include, one, elections. The law is saying that every member of a political party leader must be democratically elected at all levels. But we have never seen this happening. So we are suggesting that this must be put with the other clause. And some of the clause that we are saying is the political party council must provide an oversight role. They must observe those elections. And they must ensure that those elections are very important. The other thing is that this country, we have not been seeing political parties participating, is because the issue of funding. The law is restrictive. The law restricts political parties not from getting funding from foreign donation. And they're supposed to get their funding from the local investment within themselves. So this has proved to be very difficult for the political parties. So we are suggesting we must establish the political parties fund. We even went as far as, what is that fund? How are political parties going to get this funding? And where is the youth interest in this funding? Because this is very important for any other democratization of South Sudan. So we are saying even the issues of funding must be addressed. And we are suggesting that the 5% of the national revenue collected in that particular financial year should go to the political parties fund. We are even suggesting that this must be managed by the political party council so that political parties are able to do their work. But right now they cannot do their work because of funding. And if you do your research well, you ask all political parties, they tell you, we're not doing our work because we don't have the funding. But when we have a funding system put in place, you see political parties being very active in advancing their political agenda. The other thing we also suggested, which is very important, which is not in any other legal framework, is what is called the Political Party Leadership Forum. This was established when the political leadership of this country had a social dialogue years back. And they established this forum so that political parties leaders can be able to congregate and deliberate on very important issues of this country. So we are saying this political party leadership forum must not go into the dustbin. We must ensure that this forum is there. And in case there is a crisis, in case there are issues that need a national platform, the political leaders need to make decision on it, and then this forum will be able to litigate on this issue. We even went as far as defining this forum, what is it going to be all about. For example, if there is an issue of economic crisis, the political leaders will have answers to this economic crisis. So the political leadership forum will be able to sit down and litigate on these issues and look how do we address the issues of economic crisis. Is the political leadership of this country. We're also borrowing from our neighboring countries where there is no platform where the leaders can sit, political leaders can sit and deliberate. So we are saying we must provide for that forum so that if there is any problem, they are able to sit down as leaders of the political parties and provide for political solution where there is a political problem in the country. So that is one of the jurisprudence that is not even in any other law in the world. It is the youth also that recommending based on the principle that this has worked before, and by the way, it has worked so well before, and the political leadership can bear as witness how this forum has been very important to them. So we said this matter should not only be left, must be put in the law so that they are able to congregate and discuss the real fundamental issues. For example, also, if there are issues related to elections in future, for example, the issues of appointment of commissioners, if the political leaders disagree on who should be the chairman, who should be the secretary general, who should be this, where will they meet to deliberate to see how they will reach to a compromise? Because at the end of the day, they must reach to a compromise. So I say this forum is very important so that they're able to have a table where they can reach to a compromise. Even we suggested in that forum, we must have
another body, which is the religious leaders, to provide an observatory role. They are like observers in that forum. And we are saying, instead of giving the leadership of the PPLF to a political leader, political party leader, let the chairman of the political party council chair the meeting. And you have any other group. And we're even saying, in this forum, we do not want these other lower leaders of the party. We're recommending is the chairman of the party or the party leader. In the absence of the chairman of the party, it is either the deputy chairperson or the secretary general of the party. These are the people who will congregate. And this is only a call when there are important political issues that need to be discussed, that the political leadership has to come on board and have a drawing board. So this has been lacking in this country. This is what we are suggesting, that this must be put in the law, and so that we have a platform where the political leaders can sit and congregate.
What other message do you have for the leadership?
For my fellow youth is that let us have our voice heard. This is a very important event that processes an event that are happening in this country. We have to start, shaping the future now. So the idea of us not participating in these processes should not be something that we need to adhere to. So what I'm encouraging our young people, youth, is that let us be participating in every political process. Whether it is a permanent constitution process, let's participate. If it is the National Election Act review of that law, let us participate. If it is about the national dialogue, let us participate. In any process, let us find our way how our views is to be heard, because we are shaping the future for now and even for the future. But when we leave this to the political leaders, when you leave this to other people, we said, after all, this is about politics. This is not about politics. This is about political process. This is about our life, because when the political leaders disagree, it affects the citizen. So we are saying this process must be, we have to look into different scenarios so that we fill up this gap. So I want to encourage the young people, let us participate in all these processes that are going on. Let's find our way. When you find your way there, please let your voice be heard. And please network with the rest so that you have a very unified position. So that it's not only yourself talking, but it's the position of every young person in this country. So I want to encourage them to participate in any political process. And we are open that this submission also will be able to do civic education on this submission that we are suggesting. And it's our hope, and it is our hope that the GMEC, and specifically the National Constitution Amendment Committee, adhered to our recommendations. It is our prayer, it is our hope that the Ministry of Justice will look into this recommendation in letter and in spirit. It is our hope as youth that the National Legislative Assembly look into this recommendation. Because, our fidelity to the constitution and law is very, very important for the democratization of this country. And inclusivity does not mean political leadership. Inclusivity means everybody in this country have a say in saying whatsoever to move this country forward. So our appeal is that they should not look at this document as something. They just need to peruse it, look into it. What is good, they get it. What is not good with them, they need to explain to us why they feel is not good with them. So we'll be knocking at everybody's door, and we ask them, please, this is our recommendation that we hope that they'll be able to buy in.
Thank you.
Thank you.